So today's plan was originally to rush high point tasks such as TOB and Nightmare in order to get within the top 50 ranks of the league. However, information spread like wildfire after Jagex talked about changing the way the last recall relic worked with God Wars. As you guys recall from my yesterday's video, I was able to teleport in and out of the Bounder's Room and farm all my drops like that, and I was planning to do that over the course of the week until I got my God Sword Blade and my Bounder's Hilt, as well as any other God Wars drops I wanted. However, with this new information, I had no idea when it could potentially get changed or nerfed, so I needed to act quickly and get my God Wars done fast. AFKing some teaks while being brain dead, and that is 99 wood cutting, 250 points earned just like that. Just like that, we earned 250 points and we're now in 16,670 points. Okay, we actually just got extremely lucky. That didn't even take us a long time. We were pickpocketing these little fuckers and we got ourselves 250 points off that diamond. 16,920 total points now. Oh my god. 90 Slayer, 2653, dude. But that was so... 2653, I don't know if I can get this 24, to be honest. But that's 90 Slayer as well. Dead? Nice. 2734, that was a little bit slower. I was choking a little bit, so I didn't want to die. I just wanted to get the completion for the task points. Another 250 points. We are now at 17,170. Alright, and that is another Jad done. 400k XP again. And we are 92 Slayer. Nice. Okay, and that is, should be the task completed. Yep, defeat a Cravecack and 100 points awarded. Okay, and that's 75 mage, which means we can use the trident once we get it. And there we go, we get an uncharged trident. I don't know what kill that's on, but we still got a bunch of these to go, but I can't be fucked to do it. It's such a slow task, I'm just gonna skip it. And that is the Trident of the Seas equipped, 100 points right there and then. And that is 93 Slayer, which means I can go do Smoke Devils. Okay, let's get this started. I've never done one of these before, so I don't know how it's gonna go, but it's already half HP, so I think this is the easiest 500 points of my life, if I'm not mistaken. Am I... Hello? Did I just get 500 points for that? Oh my god, okay, wait, I got 250 points for that. I think I need to kill a normal one for another 250 points, so let me just try that real quick. Bro, and it has a mad quick respawn timer, what? Okay, well that's another one done. Is that another 250 points? Please tell me it is. Yes, it is. That's another elite task. Just like that, I jumped up from 17,370 to 17,870. Awesome. Time to make our way back to Bandos. We had already completed it four times over, but I was still looking for the hilt as well as God Sword Shard 2 to complete my blade. Once I got the hilt here, I could make my way to Zami as it would be easier to farm the shard there on task for faster kills. Okay, and that is 200 KC. Can I get my hilt here, please? It'd be amazing if I could. And... I got grimy snapdragons, but I agree. I just got my third tassets, bro. Bandos Hill, Bandos Hill, Bandos Hill, 224 KC. Let's fucking go. Let's go. Bandos completed in 224 KC, and I mean really completed, as we even got the pet yesterday. It was time to move on to Zami where we could kill it on task. A spear and a staff from Zami are both 250 points each, and we are also very keen to get ourselves God Sword Shard 1 and 2. Okay, 100 points, 100 points, 100 points for defeating Krill Tistothoroth? Steam Battle Staff, isn't that a thing? Isn't that a task? Oh, dude, equip a combination battle staff or misty staff for 100 points. Okay, I guess I haven't. God Sword Shard 1! God Sword Shard 1! Yes, let's go! Let's go! I only need the 2 now. Zamorakid Spear, 11 KC. Wield Zamorakid Spear. Elite task, 250 points. Yes. 18.5k now, Matt. We were AFKing some range earlier and got to 67, and I forgot I had a rune crossbow in the bank. That's a hard task for 100 points right there. Zamorak Hilt, what? Let's go, 24kc. 24kc. God, plus I want to stay for the shard too as well. God Sword Shard 3, dude. That's my third God Sword Shard 3, bro. I just need 1-2, and I'm done, bro. 46, and I just got another spear, dude. Zamorakian spear, dude. 3. 60 KC, still no Staff of Dead, and no Gods of Shard 2. You need some Ditterbitter RNG, not gonna lie. As I say that, I get a fourth spear. I literally just went to one of my friends. You need some Ditterbitter RNG, and I get a fourth spear. That could have been bad. Dude, did I go to DDS Plus? I got a Dragon Dagger Poison from Thingamajiggy. Let's go. That's like the only way to get it, I think. I don't know. Okay, if I'm not mistaken, that is 120 combat, and it is 99 attack, which is two elite tasks. So I just went up 500 points just on the Sammy kill. We're currently at 88 KC or so. Look how easy it is. I don't even have to pray or flick or anything. As I say that, I just get hit down to 40 HP. But yeah, I'm on task. You just constantly destroy these things. All I'm killing is the boss. It's probably not even worth it to kill the minions. So that's what I'm doing. And our points have just jumped up to 19,170. There were a lot easier and higher point tasks available to me, but like I said, with any potential God Wars changes coming up, I had no choice but to get it done now. I was rank 108 at the end of last video, and I've been continuing gaining ranks and catching up to the people who chose Skill and Prodigy every single day. As it stands here, I took rank 63 and had even overtaken the boys' solo mission and foe, both of which had chosen Skill and Prodigy. After we're done with God Wars Dungeon, we can really start climbing and looking towards making it into the top 25. Right now we're chasing that staff and we're chasing Godsword Shard 2, and then we can move on to Sara. Another spear! 90 KC. 90 KC spear. That's my fifth spear. Still no staff. 100 KC. Adamant Arrows. P++. Let's fucking go. 94 Slayer. Godsword Shard 1. 143 kill count. I just need two. Godsword Shard 2, let's go! Let's go, dude, finally, 150 KC as well. Okay, and that is the Knight Sword done, putting me to 79 smithing, right where I need to be, as I can now boost to 80 smithing to make myself my Godsword Blade. We buy ourselves a nice little Dwarven Stout here, which we can drink, that gives us a permanent boost to 80 as we have Botanist. And now we get to make our Godsword. Let's use the Godsword Shard on the anvil or whatever. Okay, Godsword Shards 1 and 2, add Godsword Shard 3 to that. I don't even know how you do it. Okay, do it like that. Sorry, I'm new to this. I've never made my own Godsword before. Leave me alone. Okay, that is the Godsword Blade right there. Attach it. Boom. A BGS. 250 points. Equip a Godsword. Just like that. And we can switch it whenever we want with our Zamorak hilt. I think we just do that. Dismantle. And then we put it onto there. ZGS. Just like that. Two Godswords already. It is now time to show you guys why I have been hyping up the Bandos Godsword so much, and why it is one of the best and most powerful unlocks in the league, and why I wanted to get it so early. Now if you guys know, to get an ACB or a Sara hilt from Sara, you'd have to do a very slow killing method with range where you'd constantly be clicking around the room. However, with the BGS and the weapon specialist relic that I have, I can simply BGS spec Zilliana 5 times in a row, and basically slice through her like butter. And this applies for many more bosses throughout the league. Let me show you. Alright, let's teleport into Sara. Hopefully there's no one in this world so I can show you guys real quick. Yup. No, don't BGS the wrong thing. That would have been awkward. Anyway, ZGS, BGS spec Zilliana. If the first one fails, not that big a deal. Second one fails, maybe not that big a deal. Third one, 25. Fourth one is a 37, and this kill should be fine just there. A 69. Did you see that? I don't think I've ever hit a 69 on the league before. But as you can see, just after 5 BGS hits, it's already on 25% health. And its defense is already lowered so much, I just have to hit it with a few whip hits, and it should go down pretty easily. One more whip hit, and it is dead just like that, I want to say. Very quick and simple, I don't have to run around ranging it and taking forever for the kills. That's why I wanted to unlock the BGS so early. It's going to make this grind and a lot of other grinds so much better, because 5 times BGSing something right at the start and getting beat, like I'm already back at 30% special attack. The BGS is just so strong, it's going to help me out so much, and once I get a Sara Domain hilt from Zilliana, I'll be able to heal myself as well with a 5x SGS spec. 5x SGS spec, 5x BGS spec, and everywhere I go, I'll never need food, I'll never need prayer, and most importantly, I'll be destroying every boss I do with the BGS. It's amazing. Managed to complete my Godsword Blade today, as well as get both the Zamorak and the Bandos hilt, which means I have access to both the BGS and the ZGS. Now as I showed you guys today, the BGS is extremely good for PVM, and especially for the Sara Domain method that I was showing you guys. I'm not sure what's going to happen to the God Wars Dungeon recall methods, which is why tomorrow I'm coming right back to Sara to get my ACB and my Sara Domain hilt. Once we get that, we can potentially move into some Nightmare or TOB. You guys have been killing it with the support lately, so if you guys have enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like as well as subscribe if you are new so you don't miss a single upload from me during this leagues. Thanks for watching today's video, and I will see you guys later.